Hello friends. Today I have the great pleasure of being with Sam Thenabadu from Guy's King's and St. Thomas' School of Medicine. Sam, welcome.
Thank you.
Really excited to meet you. Tell us about your new role within the medical school, please.
Well, thanks so much for inviting me to have this conversation with you. It's a pleasure and something that I hope we do going forward lots and lots. It's an exciting time for our medical school. I've been part of the medical school for a long time. I studied here, in fact, in the 90s. So I haven't gone too far. You don't go too far when you're happy, I think. And I studied at King's. I was part of GKT when it merged. And I've been part of as a trainee and as a junior member of faculty for a long period of time. I'm very lucky in the last 6 months I've taken on the role as program director of the MBBS. So privileged to look after everything from day one through to graduation. And for us, that's beyond graduation as well. I think you also believe that these are GKT alumni. We want them to be with us, not just during medical school, but onwards. It's an exciting time for us. You know that so much has changed in the last 5 years. For us, we had a major curriculum change. The curriculum that I studied in the 90s, we were still delivering. So some may say it was time for an upgrade. But the reason we changed it was to make it fit for purpose, make it what we need for today's doctors. I'm excited that we've got a really good curriculum now, but in between that delivery, COVID came along. So we've had some significant challenges in how we deliver that. But you yourself, so passionate about surgery and the delivery of surgery, it's one of our key priorities. Some may say, well, where is your surgery? And my comeback to that is it's now everywhere during the program. We run a program which is actually now divided into three sections, the foundations, then from what we call science to clinical practice, and then integrating clinical practice. So three distinct areas that we hope that students will evolve into. And if we think about surgery, I suspect as a professor of surgery, you would believe that the foundations are absolutely core before you can move forward, and understanding the link between science and the clinical delivery. And then how do we make you a better surgeon? So that, in essence, is what we're trying to deliver at the moment.
You brought in COVID. We can't ignore it. It ruled our lives for 2+ years. It was disastrous for our students. So tell us how COVID has made us as a medical school evolve for the sake of surgical education and its delivery for our students.
Well, of all the specialties, surgery suffered, didn't they? You as a surgeon will know that your life in theatre changed completely. Who you were with, what you were wearing, you know, how patients were prepared. Every single aspect changed. For us, education had to continue, but the challenges were there of how we could have our students within that setting so they could learn from you, learn from your team. And for a certain period of time, we had to pause that. And I think for safety, that was for patient safety, for your safety, your team's safety. But as quick as we could, we wanted to get back to work and to understand what were the conditions that we could work under that remained safe for your team, for the patient, but that students could learn through. And actually, I'm now at a point where I'm thinking about the silver linings. What did we get that was good that we would keep? You yourself have delivered so much online teaching, so much that we're excited about. Could we be streaming, you know, from live from the theatre? Could we be using recordings with consent, of course, that we can use this? So we've had pockets of great practice like that. And now is the time to see how can we really develop those areas. Students learn best, I feel, by doing. And when they are your assistant, are your apprentice, they will learn. The textbooks are there. Of course, they need to study from that. I said the science, the foundations need to be there. But what COVID has shown us is that it's hard to learn if you're not being side by side with colleagues. And actually, I think that's inspired our colleagues. It's inspired our faculty to say, I've missed the students being here. Always welcoming, but particularly welcoming at the moment. And inspired our students in saying, well, hold on a minute. I tried to learn from those textbooks. I did use the online resources. But if we can bring it together, all those parts together, the book knowledge, the online fantastic contents, and your support. So we're evolving this in understanding how we can use all those three areas that we had to develop and to maximize it, really.
Yeah, I remember we used to do surgery without boundaries. We couldn't bring the students into the operating room. So we took the operating room to them using an augmented reality platform called Proxime, developed here at Guy's and St. Thomas's by one of our plastic surgeons. So I thought that was extremely useful.
Yeah.
With our BSc in surgical science, we have a lot of technical skills training, so simulation and so on. Patient safety without harming patients, I think. But tell me more about the curriculum itself. You know, MBBS 2020, now we are in 2023. What's happening? What's new?
Well, the cynic may say to me, well, where is surgery? Show me the block that we do it in. When is the 6 weeks, 8 weeks? I think when I was at medical school, I think I did a 10-week surgical block. I did general surgery. I know I did general surgery. It was wonderful. I enjoyed it. And I did surgical on calls, and I saw, of course, anyone that came in during that time period. Now what we've done is we've ensured that you have every aspect of surgery throughout the course, from year two onwards, year two, year three, four, five. And as I very keen that you mentioned, the IBSC is there where we're seeing greater uptake all the time of the surgical BSCs and masters. So we have now spread that surgery everywhere. And I think that's based on good educational principles of not just having a one-off episode, which may be fortuitous if you're with someone that really wants to take you under their wing, moving that away from that one-off episode to really building foundations, revisiting areas. And the place that we've really seen the benefit for that is students understanding, what does theatre look like? How can I orientate myself? We all know that the first time we go anywhere, it can be daunting.
Indeed.
Surgery is not something to be taken lightly.
Absolutely.
To see a student in second year evolve in the third year to say, well, actually, no, I understand how to scrub. Fourth year, well, actually, maybe I can assist, does it? Maybe I can close. To see those final years actually having their name on the surgical script. Exactly. And what a proud moment for a student to be on the operating note. So that is the way we've seen it evolve. And I'm pleased that you mentioned about simulation as well, something that we're so passionate about at the school, to see real-life surgeons saying real-life scenarios, bringing them to the simulation lab, doing it in a safe setting. What a great way to learn there. And not just the common things for our students, but those rare occurrences that we do want them to know about as well. Things that you're delivering to your registrars, we're actually bringing forward and delivering them to our students.
Now tell me this. Surgery is a craft specialty. There's no going away from that.
Yes.
You need to do things with your hands.
Absolutely.
How do we inspire the GKT students who want to become surgeons? How do we provide them with role models? For example, I mean, you and I had role models. What do we do for the students? Or do you think education today in surgery doesn't need role models?
Personally, I always think if you have someone to look up to, aspire to follow in their footsteps, I think that's from the beginning of time we've had that. I don't see it going away, Prokar. But what we need are passionate educators, highly skilled surgeons that are willing to put themselves out there and say, this is my journey. And I'm so keen to work with yourself and colleagues to have champions for all our surgical specialties to say, this was my journey. This is how we got to that. It's not easy, but you can, you know, we will help you on that way. So champions are something that we're looking to instill back into the medical school. We've had them over the years, but really, who is our urology champion? I may come to you. Who is our plastic surgeon champion? You know, so that we have these role models. And just show students that they're not limited to you know, cliches. You know, only a certain type of person can do this. Not at all. I think at King's, what we have is a very diverse group of students with a cosmopolitan group of faculty who can really inspire. And this generation, you know, they're calling out for it. And I think that we're very, very lucky at GKT. We've got great champions. So I'll be knocking on your door to see how we can have you on board to help us.
What about the KCL Surgical Society and its mentorship scheme, which you very kindly approved? Do you think that's a good thing?
Societies are the backbone of inspiring. You know, they're the spark to me. And to see colleagues championing those societies, it heartens me. I remember being in societies and thinking, where will this go? Well, it goes somewhere now. To think about a society peers meeting and then to have junior surgeons, registrars, senior colleagues like yourself, giving them the time has made such a difference to them. It opens doors. You know, and it opens their mind more than anything of what opportunities are there for them. So it's made a huge difference, and it's something that this year societies are a huge priority for us. you and I both know that the individuals there, they will probably be our peers in 15 years' time. They'll be the professors of that generation. But it's wonderful to look back and think that this is where it started.
Sam, thank you so much. A clear message from Sam Thenabadu to our students. Surgery today at King's is in a better place than it was 5 years ago. I have no doubt about it. Neither does Sam. I urge you to join us. All students who aspire to become surgeons, please get in touch with Sam and I, and we'll help you achieve your goals.